Peace be unto you and your family. 11th chemistry unit 1 basic concept of chemistry and chemical calculations. Lesson by question from 34 to 38. Calculate the average atomic mass of naturally occurring magnesium using the following data. In question, the isotopes of magnesium is given. That is, magnesium 2 plus isotopic atomic mass 23.99, abundance 78.99, magnesium 25 24.99, abundance 10, magnesium 26 25.98 and abundance 11.01. First we have to calculate the individual atomic mass of all these isotopes. Magnesium 24, the atomic mass is, isotopic atomic mass 23.99 and abundance 78.99 divided by 100. That is equal to, when you multiply these two, we will get the answer 1894. So 1894 by 100, 100 is nothing but 10 power 2. When you bring 10 power 2 to the numerator, it becomes 10 power minus 2. And 1894 into 10 power minus 2 will give the answer 18.94. is the atomic mass of magnesium 24. Now, for magnesium 25, the percentage is 24.99. Abundance given in our problem is 10 divided by 100. 100 means 10 power 2, bring the 10 power 2 to the numerator, it becomes 10 power minus 2. 10 means 10 power 1, that is equal to 24.99 into 10 power 1 into 10 power minus 2. 10 power 1, 10 power minus 2 equal to 10 power minus 1, and multiply 10 power minus 1 with 24.99, it will give the answer 2.499. For magnesium 26, the atomic mass, the isotopic atomic mass is 25.98 and abundance 11.01 divided by 100 will give the answer. The multiplication value will give the answer 286.0. 286.0 divided by 100. When you bring 100, that means 10 power 2 to the numerator, it becomes 10 power minus 2. Multiple 286 into 10 power minus 2, you will get the answer 2.86. Now, when you sum up all the 18.94, 2.499 and 2.86, the average mass of magnesium is, when we sum up all these, the correct answer is 24.299 is the correct relative atomic average atomic mass of magnesium. This is question number 34, come to 35. Problem number 35 is a limiting reagent problem. In a reaction, X plus Y plus Z2 gives XYZ2. Identify the limiting reagent, if any, in the following reaction mixture. 200 atoms of X, 200 atoms of Y, 50 molecules of Z2. 50 is the limiting reagent. 1 mole of X, 1 mole of Y, 3 moles of X2. 1 limiting reagent. 50 atoms of X plus 25 atoms of Y plus 50 molecules of Z2. So, this Y is a limiting reagent. 2.5 mole of X, 5 mole of Y and 5 mole of Z2. X is a limiting reagent. The reaction is X plus Y plus Z2 gives a XYZ2. This is our question, but XA 200, 250, that means from before Z2 we have 111 moles. The lowest mole is taken, 50. So number of moles of reactant consumed, here 50, up like this, here 50, here 50. So 50, 50, 50. When you subtract, The Z2 is completely used up. Here we have 150, 150 after subtracting. Here all the 50 molecules are used up. Therefore, limiting reagent is X2 in the first case. Second case, this is our question, 1 mole, 1 mole, 3 mole. So, which is the lowest one? 1 mole. So, all these 1, 1, 1 means 1 mole, 1 mole, 1 mole undergo reacted. So, these two are completely used up. This is in excess reagent, 2 moles excess reagent. Therefore, the limiting reagent is X and Y. Come to the third one, see. 50 molecule. Which one is the lowest value? 25 atom is the lowest value. Therefore, here 25, 25, 25 molecules are used here. So, 50 minus 25 equal to remaining 25 we have. Here 25 minus 25 equal to 0, Y is the limiting reagent. The last one is 2.5 mole, 5 mole, 5 mole. Which one is lowest one? 2.5. So, 2.5 moles of X, Y, Z undergo reaction. When you subtract, this becomes 0. So, X is the limiting reagent. Question number 35 is over. Question number 36. Mass of one atom of an element is 6.645 into 10 power minus 23 gram. How many moles of element are there in 0.320 kilogram? Mass of one atom is given 6.645 into 10 power minus 23 gram. Mass of one mole of an atom, that mass is multiplied by Avogadro number 6.022 into 10 power 23. 10 power minus 23, 10 power plus 23 get cancelled. When you multiply these two, the answer is 40.01, approximately taken as 40 gram. 40 gram equal to 1 mole. We know 0.320 kilogram equal to how many gram? 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. When you multiply this value by 1000, you will get 320 gram. Therefore, 40 gram is 1 mole, 0.320 kilogram means convert this into gram, 320 grams multiple divided by this value, 320 into 1 divided by 40. Easy answer, 0, 0 get cancelled, 1, 4 is 4, how many 4s are 32? 8 4s are 32. That is equal to, so the answer is 8 moles is the answer. 36 this is. Come to question number 37. What is the difference between molecular mass and molar mass? Calculate the molecular mass and molar mass for carbon monoxide. Molecular mass definition, it may be asked individually in 2-mark question also. Define molar mass or molecular mass. Relative molecular mass is defined as the ratio of the mass of a molecule to the unified atomic mass unit. Molar mass is defined as the mass of one mole of a substance. How to calculate the molar mass? The relative molar mass of any compound can be calculated by adding the relative atomic masses of its constituent atoms. The molar mass of a compound is equal to the sum of the relative atomic mass of the constituent atom expressed in gram mole power minus 1. The unit is U or AMU. The unit is gram mole power minus 1. How to calculate the molecular mass of carbon monoxide? Carbon monoxide contains one carbon atom and one oxygen atom. That is equal to 1 into carbon atomic mass 12 and 1 into oxygen atomic mass 16. That is equal to 28. U is the unit of molecular mass. Molar mass 1 carbon plus 1 oxygen equal to 1 into carbon 12 plus 1 into oxygen 16 equal to 28. Unit is gram mole power minus 1. There is no change in the magnitude. Change is only in the unit. Question number 38, oftenly asked in 2-mark question. Question number 38. What is the empirical formula of the following? Fructose, C6H12O6, found in honey. And caffeine, C8H10N4O2, a substance found in tea and coffee. Compound fructose, molecular formula C6H12O6. The common number is 6. When all these numbers divided by 6, you will give CH2O. Caffeine, C8H10N4O2, common number is 2, lowest number is 2. When you divide all these numbers by 2, you will get C4H5N2O. So, up to question number 38, we completed in this video. Question number 39, start in the second video. Thank you for watching. If you like, please subscribe, share and like. Thank you very much.